Happy holidays, Gundam fans, and in day 9, we're going to be looking at the 100 Master Grade Gundam Hazel, which is from Magic Toys. It's another company that made one kit and then just poof, disappeared. But this is a really, really good kit. It does have flaws, but it does look great. It came out in 2015, and I think the Bandai version came out in 2017, so this was out for at least 2 years before Bandai decided to release theirs, as P-Bandai, of course, is definitely more expensive than this was when I first bought it. I don't know if you can find it nowadays, but it does look great. You can't tell me this thing doesn't look just like the Hazel. Now, sticker-wise, well, you just got, like, the head. It has a clear, forehead piece. And I think that's it. Like, it's very detailed. And, look, even clear, parts of the, thrusters. No lights, but it's cool. And it does have the one shield, like, the GM shield. It has the, shield booster. You can also peg onto the other arm if you want. It has the appropriate rifle. It has, the extra clips here, which are just for show. Which I think the Bandai version is, too. Now, its problem, it goes together, it holds together fairly well, it looks great, it has the right weapons, the problem is it's very loose in the joints. The knees are okay, the hips are loose, the ankles are a little loose, not horrible, I like the pistons in there. The shoulders at the rotate here at the bicep are loose, the hands are very loose, they don't fall out, nothing falls out like the stomach joint is loose, but it doesn't fall apart, it just has a lot of loose joints, which could be fixed with a little bit of, like, super glue or floor polish, probably, to thicken up the ball joints and the hinges and so on. Because, like, as you can see, it stands fine, and the feet are pretty big. The Hazel is known for having a larger lower half, pretty much. So it will stand, it's just like I said, it has a little trouble with stability. But it looks great. I did buy the official one as the Titan Advanced, I think it was. And I had the two Harutadus to combine with it. Unfortunately, they do not fit with this version. I kind of wish it would, because I wouldn't have bought the official one. I would just bought the two Harutadus and given it to this guy, but they didn't work. Unfortunately, I could have maybe modified it, but whatever. I'm glad I have it. But if I didn't have that version, I'd be happy with this one, because the official one is very expensive. I just wish, once again, I wish the company had kept going, because this is, with a little bit of fine-tuning, would have been an amazing kit. But for the first attempt, it's very, very good. And like a completely unique kit, which Bandai hadn't done at the time. So that's about it. And I will see you in day 10.